So we had the ST Ericsson here at the Mobile World Congress 2011. So could you explain a little bit ST Ericsson, the company, what is it doing?
Hi, well, ST Ericsson, we build wireless semiconductors and platforms, so complete solutions for mobile phones. And here at Mobile World Congress, we announced quite a few new things. We announced three new brand names, so you see them over here. We announced the Nova, which is our high-performance application processors. We announced the Thor over here, which is our industry-leading modems. When you put the two of them together, you get a Nova Thor, which is our complete solutions for smartphones and tablets, a series of platforms.
So this has been an announcement here, right here at the Mobile World Congress.
Exactly. All of these names were announced, and the families were announced, and we announced about seven new products in the family.
And where are these products developed? Where are they made?
So we have research and development sites all over the globe. And we work across the globe to build these products.
And basically, ST Ericsson, when did that happen, that merger or that collaboration? And
so we're a two-year-old company now. Basically, we launched in Barcelona in 2009, and this year is our our third year, basically, here at the FIRA. I think this year was a big coming-out year for us. As I say, we launched seven new products, we launched the brands, and we have a lot of new things to show here.
So you have a very high-end, the highest performance Cortex A9. You also have a lower entry-level Cortex A9. First time I heard a target to have a Cortex A9 below $200 smartphones.
Yeah, we think we can do 100. Well, our customers can build $100 smartphones based on the solutions that we're able to offer them. So what we're showing here, we're showing ARM Cortex A9 dual cores. We're showing single cores. We're showing it combined with wideband CDMA, with TD-SC CDMA. We're showing it combined with 21 megabit per second modems, as well as 14 and 7.2. So we're offering our customers a full range of products that they can develop based on the same core and based on the same graphics core.
And you're the leading edge with the next generation of LTE and HSPA Plus?
Yes, we also launched two new products here in our Thor family, the Thor M7300 and M7400, an LTE modem and an 84 megabit per second HSPA Plus modem.
So you have some engineers, for example, in Sweden, and there are some in France. Can you explain a little bit what they do?
Sure. We develop the complete solution. So we have competences that came from the parent companies and from the various companies that were merged when we built ST Ericsson back in 2009. So our competencies are really spread across the world. For example, if you take modems, we do some modem development in Sweden, we do some in China for TD-SC CDMA, we do some in France for GSM, GPRS, Edge. We do it a little bit around the world. We take the best competencies wherever they are.
And how fast can you deliver, for example, let's say a huge volume? Can you have production all over the world?
So we have we're a foundry-less company.
Yeah.
We work very closely with our parent ST and also with many of the leading foundries around the world. And so we have we're able to ramp very quickly. And we have a lot of experience, even though we're a fabless company. Two of the companies that formed the joint venture were actually companies with fabs before, so we have a lot of experience in foundry and in packaging and in ramping up these products very fast.
All right, thanks for that. So you announced Cortex A15.
Yes, we're very excited about that. We launched, we announced a Cortex A15, dual Cortex A15, with each core running up to 2.5 gigahertz. So this is the next generation of application processor. We believe that will really be game changing in terms of the performance that will be available to developers to create the next experience.
So how fast are you moving into that generation?
So we'll be sampling that this year, and we expect that to be seeing that in ready for mass production second half of next year or early the year after.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.